Today we are turning animals into dragons.
I'm so excited.
Jazza and I have already done a video like this where we've selected really fun animals and turned them into dragons, basically giving them wings and horns and making them look epic. We actually picked animals like out of a hat or out of a bowl. But at the end of the video, we did like a little teaser where we picked a penguin and a cheetah. And you guys really liked that. You guys like went absolutely off in the Discord community, making awesome fan art for cheetah and penguin art. So I'm gonna be doing a penguin today.
And I get to do the cheetah.
It's gonna be so much fun.
It's really appropriate that you've worn like a spotty bow on your hair today.
Mm-hmm.
I think the first thing I decided on this was whether I was gonna do a like Eastern dragon or a Western European dragon.
They're very different, aren't they?
They're so different.
Cause like Western dragons have wings and then Eastern dragons are kind of just like long noodles that float in the sky.
It's like an extra danger noodle.
Yeah.
So I wanted an extra danger noodle. Mostly because I hate drawing like dragon wings. So difficult. I always feel like they're not big enough.
Yeah.
There's like, you know, you draw them, but then like you don't have enough space for like how much would actually they would need to carry a body like that.
Yeah, for like real, I guess more realistic sort of proportions. Because they're so heavy, right? They're not birds. They don't have like
bird
empty bones.
Maybe they do.
So you're gonna need like gigantic wings that take up half of the artwork and a tiny little body.
Yeah.
So I think you've picked the right choice.
And also like cheetah bodies are kind of shaped like danger noodles if you think about it when they're running.
They're very lean cats, aren't they?
So that made sense to me.
I think because I associate dragon wings with like bat wings and they have like skin on them, I feel like it wouldn't be the best fit for a cheetah, which is normally furry.
No, that's true. That would be kind of like weird. That's like an ick factor actually.
It would feel like the wings are like shaved. It's like he gets his wings waxed or something.
I ended up picking the Eastern as well because I imagine them, like in my head, they're really fast. Like I kind of picture like Spirited Away and Haku just like in the sky being like,
yeah. We're gonna have to cut from the voiceover to the actual the footage of that. I feel like Asian dragons also tend to have fur on them, like that dragon in Spirited Away. They have like a mane.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if Western dragons tend to have that fur as well. They tend to be more like scaly.
Spikes, yeah.
Yeah, I think so. And like horns. And Eastern dragons tend to have whiskers as well, as sort of an extension of that fur. So it's definitely suited to furrier animals.
Yeah.
One thing that I thought was so fun and unique to your cheetah dragon was the shape of the, like the spine, the spikes along its back.
Oh yeah.
Because usually they're quite sharp and spiky, but you've actually gone for like round, like
they humps. Look like,
yeah, humps.
He's a million humped camel.
One thing that I love about having spikes down a dragon's back is that it really shows off the form of the creature.
Yes, especially with the way that I've done the, like the way the body's sitting, like it's very confusing unless you can see where the actual backbone takes place.
That's my favorite part about drawing dragons because you can like get some really twisted, like interesting poses.
We should do snakes.
Snakes as dragons? Is that just a dragon?
Sorry, Alicia, I just have to insert myself here because we have some huge news for digital artists. Because Hueon, who makes some of the most incredible digital art tablets out there, are launching some epic Black Friday sales and they've sponsored this video so we can tell you about it. We couldn't function without our Hueon tablet. We use the Canvas Pro 24 4K every day here at Insert Art. Sketching, digital painting and detailed line work are incredibly easy and it has a massive 24-inch screen with an incredible 4K resolution. The results are amazing because the screen can display more than 1 billion colors. The etched glass is glare resistant and Hueon's battery-free pens use Pentek 3.0 so they're incredibly accurate and flexible. For a more compact and portable option, of course though, there's the Canvas Pro 16, 2.5K display. Hueon's Black Friday sales run from November 21st to November 30th, and they're also offering free shipping for any order over $100. I just had to jump in here and tell you this myself because this is an incredible deal. In fact, I don't think I've ever seen discounts or deals this awesome for such high-end products. So now is the time to go check out Hueon. The link is in the description. You know what to do. Go support your own art and insert a digital tablet into your life in the link in the description. And huge thank you to Hueon for sponsoring.
So it's funny that you did an Eastern-inspired dragon because I also did an Eastern-inspired dragon. Again, like also because I didn't really want to draw dragon wings. I kind of had the idea that drawing a dragon with like lots of flippers or like really big flippers would be like more fun and more penguin-y.
All I imagined just then was like a centipede dragon with lots of little flippers.
Oh, no. Definitely not that. But I did want to include a few like extra flippers because then, I don't know, it just feels more magical, yeah, more fun than just having one set.
And it has to get through the water, right?
Yeah.
The water air.
Exactly. And then I remembered that penguins are Antarctic creatures, so they live in very cold conditions. And usually, like penguins and seals and, you know, creatures that live in very cold conditions, they have a really thick layer of like blubber to them. Like they've got a little bit of fat to keep them warm. So I kind of started with this really long, skinny noodle and just gradually made it fatter and fatter.
Like, fed him?
Yeah. Yeah, so I imagine this dragon definitely eats fish.
Yeah.
Like underwater, whatever penguins eat, obviously.
Yeah. Nice.
It's really fun to take inspiration from actual animals.
Yeah.
And I couldn't decide on which penguin to base this off because I kind of wanted to do like a fluffy gray, like child penguin.
Yes.
Or I was also thinking like a rockhopper penguin, like Lovelace from Happy Feet.
Yes.
With the
crazy,
the feathers, yeah, like the yellow feathers, like as ears basically. But I decided that I wanted this penguin to be really like slippery and shiny and I don't know, just very sleek. I feel like dragons are very sleek, yeah, so I wanted to pick a very sleek penguin to base it off of. And I decided to go for the emperor penguin.
Classic.
I feel like it's just like I don't really know a lot of other penguin species, so I was like, yeah, emperor penguin, that'd do the job.
Nice.
I also decided to give my dragon a really short tail.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like I was a little bit in two minds about this because dragons tend to have very long tails. But penguins have very, very small tails. They're just kind of like a few feathers on the butt.
Yeah.
So I kind of went for like a small, medium-sized tail. So it still felt a little bit dragony, but had those penguin influences.
Kind of makes me think of a platypus. Platypuses are actually dragons, small dragons.
I also knew I wanted this dragon to have the ability to swim, but not necessarily to fly. I decided to give it an extra pair of flippers, I guess. They're sort of like these underwater wings that I imagine they would make him faster in the water, but they probably don't in reality.
Like a spoiler on a car.
Yeah, they're kind of, yeah, exactly. Or like a stingray or something. It's sort of got these like longer, flatter, wider fins that sort of resemble wings in terms of placement and size.
Mm-hmm.
And then I kind of imagined how this animal would like walk around on the ice.
Oh yeah.
A lot of the fan art that was submitted, people would draw the penguins upright so they'd have wings and they could walk around on their feet. But I just imagined this penguin like sliding on across the ice.
I was imagining his front, so this is like a snake, and then he just runs with his feet.
Yeah, exactly. It's like that pose that polar bears do where their chest is on the ice and they're like dragging themselves along with their feet. Because he's got to be able to like slide around on the ice and also swim in the water. So we were so stoked seeing all your fan art on Discord. This first one, we've got a cheetah or a leopard by Eva. It looks awesome. It looks a lot like yours, actually.
It does. I like very intentionally did not look at the fan art before I did mine.
Yeah, because we can't like, we've got to make it our own.
Yeah,
you know?
I don't want
any like subconscious, like we don't want to accidentally plagiarize someone's work.
Yeah, but it seems like Eva's kind of gone the European version.
Yeah, it's still got like the length to it,
yeah,
but it's got the addition of the very classic dragon wings. And I actually love seeing the spots on the wings.
Yeah.
I feel like that was a bit of a missed opportunity.
That's true. That would have been cool with like light in the background.
Yeah.
So it was like see-through spots.
Oh yeah, like the subsurface scattering or something.
Uh-huh.
Oh, that would have been very cool.
Next time.
This one by Army is awesome. This is so cool.
It's like a Pokemon.
I know. It's like, yeah, it's got like a fiery tail.
It's so cool.
And the same antlers that you did.
Yeah.
You have a ferret dragon by V. That is awesome.
The rendering on this is amazing.
I love the colors, especially with the background as well. Just like beautiful deep green, really complements all the browns you've got going.
I'm kind of amused by all the whiskers.
There's so many whiskers. They're so cool. Chipmunk dragon.
And traditional.
By Rowan. Very cool. I'm not sure if chipmunks are related, but they're small and furry.
My brain thought he had a cupcake, but then I realized it's an acorn and it's...
It's tiny.
Is it? Yeah.
It's like chipmunk size.
It's like this
but a dragon. Big. Last but not least, we have a rhino dragon by, excuse me if I get this wrong, LCC?
It's fun time reading usernames sometimes.
I've got no idea if I should go by the Discord name or the signature name or the Discord nickname now.
But either way, cool dragon.
Awesome dragon.
I love the colors.
It feels like the mother dragon of How to Train Your Dragons. You know, the really gigantic one that's like really, it looks like a really old, like ancient, like gigantic dragon. It looks so cool.
The shape of the head is amazing.
I've already commented about this one in the Discord, but I think the colors are so cool. It's really giving that like, kind of like earthy, almost like gemstone kind of feel.
I love that it's like rocks floating around it, like it's got some sort of, like it doesn't fly, it floats. Like,
yeah.
It like defies gravity along with some rocks.
It feels like it's got some earth, like elemental powers to it.
It's like an ancient being, it's so cool.
Next time on Insert Art, we draw an octopus and a flamingo as dragons.
Hell yeah. But before we do that, we want to see your insert fan art in the Discord.
We had so much fun looking at what you guys came up with this time, so I can't wait to see the next lot.
Even if it's not an octopus or a flamingo, any animal that you can think of can be turned into a dragon. You can do it.
I wanted to do a beta fish, like a fighting fish this time.
That would be so cool.
I want to see you guys do that because I didn't get to.
Yes, absolutely. So thank you everyone on Discord who submitted a piece of fan art. It was awesome to see. And an extra big thank you to our wonderful patrons.
You've
got a bunch of tutorials and masterclasses, polls and behind the scenes content. We can even do like a how to draw a dragon tutorial if you guys want. You guys get to vote on all our content, so you can definitely vote on how to draw a dragon and we can make a tutorial on Patreon.
Patreons, can you how to draw a danger needle?
An extra big thank you to our wonderful sponsors Huion as well. Thank you so much for sponsoring this video. The link for the Huion Black Friday sale is in the description below.
I'm going to go get my grubby paws on some cheap Huion stuff.
Oh, yeah. I just bought one for home.
Really?
Yeah, That's so exciting. It's like the gigantic one.
Oh, my God. I'm so jealous.
Yeah. If you guys like seeing animals as dragons, then give this video a like, a comment, a share, a subscribe, all of those good things. And we can just keep making more.
We just become the dragon channel.
The dragon. I mean, I wouldn't be mad at that.
Next time, it's insert artists as dragons.